Welcome back to Dvbs Sunday 2021 with me, your moderator, Ivina Sayer. Now, I know you're watching this online. Maybe you're watching it from Hope TV, Hope FM, or Citam Church Online. Just go like, go follow, go share. And our hashtag is hashtag next level. Now, we all know God is everything, right? So I want to welcome Baraka. But before I do that, we're going to be having a lot of activities. So we're going to be having prayer, have marching, you know, the DVBS style. Now, Nathan Baraka, can you please come and pray for us?
Thank you, Ivy. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, we come before you thanking you, Lord, for this day. Thank you for the gift of life. And thank you that we could all listen from home, O Lord. Heavenly Father, we come before you, Lord, asking you, the all-powerful God, to heal people who have COVID, O Lord. I pray that you bring this COVID infection rate down, O Lord, because you're the God who heals. And you said by your stripes you are healed, O Lord. Those who have COVID, O Lord, please, Lord, heal them, O Lord. And, O Lord, thank you for creating us, O Lord. And some people are sick, Heavenly Father. But you said you're Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals, O Lord. I pray that you come and in your own way, Lord, please heal them, O Lord. And also, O Lord, there are some people who have lost their loved ones and it's hurting. Lord, we were taught that Holy Spirit, you're the comforter, O Lord. I pray that you comfort those who've lost their loved ones, O Lord. And O Lord, thank you for this holy day, O Lord. Even as we're about to go back to open school, O Lord, I pray that all will be well, that the COVID will go down, O Lord, that it will be safe and sound. And O Lord, please give us hope to go on. I thank you and I praise you. Even, O Lord, I pray that you raise up a church that fears you, O Lord, that knows your name, O Lord, that they'll follow after your ways, O Lord. Please, O Lord, rise up a church, O Lord. I thank you and I praise you, O Lord. And if there's any other need of a child that they haven't told you, I pray that you reach unto them. You're Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides, O Lord. Reach out unto them, O Lord, and be with them. Those who have not been born again, I pray that you convict them back to yourself. Thank you and I worship you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you, boys and girls, for praying with me. I hand it over to Ivy.
Thank you so much, Nathan, for that beautiful word of prayer. Now it's time for our traditional DVBS parade, which are going to be led by Pastor Tabby and Tim. Come on.
Thank you so much, Ivy. Good morning, boys and girls. This is DVBS Sunday. My name is Tabby and...
And my name is Tim Elvry. How are you doing? It's so nice to see you. And today, Manze, this week has been crazy, has been awesome, has been all types of fun. And today we want to finish in style. And I'm joined here with this amazing crew. What's up, my people? Whoa, whoa, whoa. This is how we do it, this is how we do it. So I need you to stand up, I need you to stand up back there at home. Even parents, today by the parents, you're also children like us. India?
Yes.
Yes, so parents stand up, everybody stand up. We want to march. Let's see, let me see the scouts. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, scouts at ease. Attention. At ease. Attention. At ease. Proper ease. Proper ease. Attention! By the left, by the right, quick forward, march! Let's go! Left, kanyaga, left! Left, kanyaga, left! Left, kanyaga, left! 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 Here we go, here we go, here we go! All the boys and girls back at home. Everybody, I need you to join us together as we praise our God, ready to do the pledges. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Put your hands up. Let's go. Hey, nice. I can't see you. Alright, take it down like this. I can't see you. Some of you are not doing at home. I can see you. Brayo, can you do it? Stacy, let's go. Of you, if you love Jesus, make some noise. All right, boys and girls, welcome once again to Dvbs 2021. And do you know our theme, guys?
Yeah.
Do you know our theme?
Yeah.
So I want us to do like that Gigi told us, India. I want us to do our theme. So what is our theme?
Just for next.
All right, let's do it with psych, okay? Okay, boys and girls at home, let's do it together. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Destined for next level.
All right. And kama kawaida, we want to start with our pledges. So, Pasi Tabs, we start with the Christian flag.
All right, we are about to do the Christian flag. Where is the Christian flag? Point the Christian flag, one hand. The right hand to your chest and the left hand extended to the flag. Let's go. I pledge
allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One brotherhood uniting all true Christians with unity and love.
Stand up for Jesus, his soldiers of the cross. Lift high his royal banner, it shall not suffer loss. From victory unto victory, his army shall he lead. Till every foe is vanquished, and Christ is Lord indeed.
All right, yes. At ease. Attention. At ease. Proper ease. Attention. So where is our Bible? All right, your right hand towards the Bible, your left to your heart. 3, 2, 1, I pledge allegiance, let's go.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will keep it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide God's words in my heart, so that I may not sin against him.
I love the Bible. I love the Bible, because I read it and I do it.
I read it and I do it. I love the Bible.
I love the Bible,
because I read it and I do it.
I can't see you at home, let's go.
I love the Bible. I love the Bible, because I read it and I do it.
Parents, boys and girls, I can't see you.
I love the Bible. I love the Bible, because I read it and I do it.
Clap for yourself.
Yay! Hello, boys and girls. It's B-A-B-U. That is Babu. I missed you. Hey, boys and girls, today we're going to laugh at Uncle Martin trying to get to the top of a building. Do you think that is easy for him? I don't know. Come with me. Let's go and watch him. Here he comes. Let's see him do it.
Hey, boys and girls. My name is Uncle Martin. And that was a lot of work. Today, I'm going to teach you something very cool, all right? So the lesson for today is called Destined for the Next Level. Yes, destined for the next level. So you gotta say it with me. Say destined for the next level. So let me show you something. See here, we have stairs. This is called a staircase, right? So we have steps right here. So I want you to look behind me and look very carefully. What do you see? You see a massive. That is a massive building. Do you see it? I want us to go all the way up.
Is he gonna make it up? He's so weak and feeble. He doesn't have strength.
Forget about what Babu is saying, all right? Forget about Babu for a minute. He said, I can't. I'm gonna prove him. And we're gonna use something called the staircase. All the way up to the top. That word again, level, all right? Top level. Great. Go with me. Come on, let's go.
Oh. Boys and girls, this right here is what we call a staircase. I gotta tell you, I shouldn't have run, because for every step I take, it takes more effort, right? That's a lot of effort to get to the next level. But we have to keep moving. We have to keep moving to the next level. Let's go, let's go.
We have to keep moving. We have to keep moving. Move with me, boys and girls. Moving. We have to keep moving. Whoo, that's a catchy tune.
We have to keep moving. We have to keep moving. And we made it. Oh, boys and girls, we made it to the top floor. That's everything we wanted to do from all the way down there. I wanted to tell you. Oh, I have to catch your breath. Isn't it interesting how the Bible also calls the Holy Spirit the breath of God? That's quite interesting. And we also need the Holy Spirit inside of us for strength,
power.
Just the same way, boys and girls, follow me on this one. Just the same way I needed strength to get all the way to this level, going through each step, going through each step, going through each step. We also need the Holy Spirit inside of us to help us in our walk with God to get to the next level. And yes, my destiny today was to get to the top level. That is destiny for me. But your destiny is to get to the next level in your relationship with God, in your schoolwork, whatever else you want to do. Trust God to take you to the next level. Over to you, Babu. I have to catch your breath, man.
Oh, thank you, Uncle Martin. Boys and girls, do you want to get to the next level? What must you do to get to the next level? Ask the Lord to fill you today with the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit of truth enables us to do all things, even these, even those that seem to be so difficult in your eyes. All right, boys and girls, let's go to the next level. Let's ask the Holy Spirit to fill us.
Before we go to the praise and worship team, I want us to make some noise for Jesus on the count of three, all right? Back there at home, let's do it together. On the count of three, I want you to shout, to dance, to jump. If you want to jump on daddy, you can jump on him, or also if on mom, and let's celebrate God. Cindy, are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
In 3, 2, 1, for Jesus.
Yes.
Join us together as we worship God. Worship team, take it away.
Watching the nightly news, don't seem to find the rhythm. Just wanna sing the blues. Feels like a song that never stops. Feels like it's never gonna. Gotta get that fire, fire back in my bones before my heart, heart turns into stone. So will somebody please pass the megaphone? I'll shout it on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Oh, hear my prayer tonight. I'm singing to the sky. Give me strength to raise my voice. Let me testify. Oh, hear my prayer tonight. Cause this is do or die. The time has come to make a choice. And I choose joy. Let it move. Let it move. Let it move. Oh, I choose joy. Like it's never gonna. Gotta get that fire, fire back in my bones before my heart, heart turns into stone. Will somebody please pass the megaphone? I'll shout it on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Oh, hear my prayer tonight. I'm singing to the sky. Give me strength to raise my voice. Let me testify. Oh, hear my prayer tonight.
Calling us to himself, and therefore our topic is God calls us to himself. That boy is carrying sin, and do you know what is sin? Sin are those things that make Jesus very, very sad. That boy is saying no to sin, no to stealing, no to bullying.
When you remember the cross, I want you to remember this. That the cross reminds us that God punishes the sin of disobedience. But also, when you remember the cross, I want you to remember that God forgives the sin of disobedience. Because of Jesus' death on the cross, your sin of disobedience can be forgiven.
And that is what God did for Israel. Because they were his children, his people that he had chosen, but then they would do so many bad things and God will bring them back again so that they can belong to him again. Again, God is saying that he knows them by name. and they are his. And that is our promise even today.
Describe the insect. How many eyes do you see? How many legs do you see? How do they usually move from one place to another? How many plants can they eat? Just like the way the locusts eat everything in all plantations, leaving the earth totally bare. It's the same way the children of Israel had lost what they had lost because they had been taken captives in Babylon. But God, in his mercies, restored all they had lost.
God also told them that he was going to do a new thing and that they should forget those bad things that had happened to them in the past. Now, this new thing that God said he was going to do, he was going to send them the Holy Spirit. Now, when the Holy Spirit was going to come upon them, he was going to help them to preach the good news. Do you know those good news? That is the good news of salvation. And God says he was able, the Holy Spirit was able to cause them to be free once again. They will go back to their land and they will be free once again. Now, children, the same Holy Spirit that was in the lives of the children of Israel is still available for us today. And you know what, boys and girls? For you to receive the Holy Spirit, you need to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior.
Learning verses, learning verses from the Bible. Memorizing them one by one. Learning verses from the Bible. Memorizing every word. I'm hiding God's word way down in my heart. I'm making it mine right from the start. God says there's nothing that will keep us apart when I'm done. Learning verses from the Bible,
memorizing them
one by one. Learning verses from the Bible, memorizing everywhere. Yay!
Thank you so much, choir, for singing us that beautiful song. Now, children have been working very hard over the week to memorize Isaiah 43. So now I'd like to invite Rashid and Tiza to present.
Hi, everyone. My name is Tiza Zawadi from Citam River.
And my name is Rashid Salwa from Citam River too.
And welcome to our memory work.
This year's Dvbs memory work is going to come from Isaiah chapter 43, verse 1 to 28. I'll be taking you from verse 1 to 14.
And I'll be taking you from verse 15 to 28. Enjoy.
But now, this is what the Lord says. He who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burnt. The flames will not set you ablaze, for I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt for your ransom, Cush and Seba in your stead, since you are precious and honored in my sight. And because I love you, I will give men in exchange for you, and people in exchange for your life. Do not be afraid, for I am with you. I'll bring back your children from the east and gather you in the west. I'll say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not hold them back. Bring my sons from afar and my daughters from the ends of the earth, all who are called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. Lead out those who have eyes but are blind, those who have ears but are deaf. All nations gather together and its people assemble. Which of them foretold this and proclaimed to us the former things? Let them bring in their witnesses to prove that they are right. You are my witness, declares the Lord. I am a servant whom I have chosen, so that you may believe me and understand that I am him. Before me no God was formed, nor will there be one after me. I am the Lord, and apart from me, there is no Savior. I have revealed and saved and proclaimed. I am not a foreign God among you. You are my witness, declares the Lord that I am God. Yes, and from ancient days I am He. No one can deliver out of my hand. When I act, who can reverse it? This is what the Lord says, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. For your sake, I'll send to Babylon and bring down as fugitives all the Babylonians in the ships in which they took pride.
I am the Lord, your Holy One, Israel's Creator, your King. This is what the Lord says. He who made a way through the sea, a path through the mighty water, who drew out the chariots and horses, the army and reinforcements together, and they lay there, never to rise again, extinguished, snuffed like a wick. Forget the former things, do not dwell on their past. See, I am doing a new thing, now it springs up, do you not perceive it? I'm making a way in the wilderness, and streams in the wasteland, and streams in the wasteland. The wild animals honor me, the jackals and the owls, because I provide water in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland, to give drink to my people, my chosen, the people I formed for myself, that they may proclaim my praise, that they may proclaim my praise. Yet you have not called on me, Jacob. You have not wearied yourselves for me, Israel. You have not brought me sheep for burnt offerings, nor honored me with your sacrifices. I have not burdened you with grain offerings, nor wearied you with demands for incense. You have not bought any fragrant calamus for me, or lavished on me the fat of your sacrifices, but you've burdened me with your sins, and wearied me with your offenses. I am he who blots out your transgressions for my own sake, and remembers your sins no more, and remembers your sins no more. Review the past for me, let us argue the matter together. Stay the case for your innocence, stay the case for your innocence. Your first father's sin, those I sent to teach you rebelled against me. Those I sent to teach you rebelled against me. So I disgrace the dignitaries of your temple, your temple. I consent Jacob to destruction, and Israel to scorn, and Israel to scorn. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rashid and Tiza, for that beautiful memory work. Tiza, you really sang the memory work well. Now I'd like to invite Alvis, all the way from Citam, Nakuru, to give us a testimony. Praise the Lord, children, as we continue with our DVBS 2021. My name is Alvis Karenga Karaoke. I fellowship at Citam Nakuru. I am a young 11-year-old boy in class 5, and I have a testimony to share. I hope it will encourage you and not scare you, but it will help you during your difficult times. In the month of February and March this year has been a hard time for me. Let me tell you, loving boys and girls, me and my family, we went through the most difficult time of my life. My brother, who is in class 7, was just about to do his exams, but he was feeling sick. He was given some antibiotics, but they didn't help. He came home for 1 week and he went back to school. After a few days, he was brought by the school van to the hospital with a high fever of 38.4, and he was given some medicine. Then he was brought home by the school van and he spent at home at the weekend. So he was admitted on Monday and for further investigations. On Tuesday, he was tested for coronavirus. After 2 days, the results were positive. He felt down, and our senior pastor, Reverend Dongondo and Reverend Jane, came and prayed with him. The whole family was tested again, and I had a shy feeling of this testing, but the Lord was with me, and I thank that I went through it. After being testing, after 2 days, the results came out. My mother told me that among the whole family, one person is positive. I just prayed to God, and I obviously told myself that it could be my mother because she was the one staying next to my brother. So I told my mom that, she actually said it was me. I cried, asking myself one question. Why me? I was admitted in War Memorial Hospital, which has very nice doctors and nurses who are friendly to me. In the evening, we went with an ambulance going at 160 kilometers per hour. It was an interesting experience, but still God was with me and I kept praying. The next day, my doctor told me that my results of my lungs were not good. So this brought me down again and I felt sad. But my mother used to stay with us until after dinner, and she used to wear 2 masks and a medical hairnet. After being hospital for some few days, we finally went to home isolation, which is really difficult, but I kept praying to the Lord as the way Jesus prayed to Lord. After being returned home, we were told to not sit in the sitting room, not eat in the dining room, because all of our family members, except from me and my brother, they were all negative. We used to eat in our isolation rooms, study there, and we used to do many things there. But after getting out of our isolation room, we used to wear a mask. So please, boys and girls, be wearing a mask, sanitizing all the time, even if you're in school, and follow the COVID-19 measures. After finally finishing our quarantine, before we went for the final test, me and my brother, we did our end of term exams. But I thank God that we performed well. Even though we were sick, the Lord protected us, and I scored 384 marks, and my brother scored 316 marks. Through my help of my teachers, and my teachers used to send me homework, so I used to appreciate them a lot. My classmates sent me some encouraging notes, and this made me feel better. Finally, we went for the final tests.
We were tested again, but this time I was not shy. I trusted in God, and it was a little bit of irritation, but I went through it. After being testing, after 2 days, the results came out, and my mother told me we were all negative. We shouted, we celebrated, we praised the Lord. So, boys and girls, if you're going through a problem, don't let the devil make you angry. Just keep praying to the Lord as I did, and you will go through it. Never think that the Lord will let you down. He brought me up. He didn't bring me down. As long as you pray, read your Bible, and do many other holy stuff. I want to say thank you for watching me, and continue watching DVBS 2021. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Alvin, for that heartwarming testimony. It broke my heart, but it also gave me encouragement. We thank the Lord for healing you and your family. So now we'd like to hear someone from Kimberley. So, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy.
Hi, everyone who is watching us on Hope TV, who is listening to us from Hope FM, and who is following us on our Citam Church online platforms. Praise the Lord, and welcome to our DVBS Sunday 2021. My name is Kimberley Litabalia. I fellowship at Citam Athiriva, and today our topic is going to be destined for the next level. Before I get into the sermon, I'd like to do a short recap of what we did the whole week. So on day one, we learned God calls us to himself. On day two, we learned God punishes the sin of disobedience. On day three, we learned God knows my name. On day four, we learned God restores all that is lost. And on day five, we learned destined for the next level. Now I'd like to take it over from day five and wrap up the whole week. Children and parents, I hope you have your Bible, your notebooks, your pens, and a beautiful smile ready to share the word of God. Let's pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I thank you for this opportunity you've given me to share your word. Lord, I ask for your Holy Spirit to speak to me, speak to your people, Lord, that they may get hope from this message, O Lord. I ask, Lord, for even for your people, Lord, may they receive hope in each and every situation they are going through. We praise you, we exalt you, for it's in Jesus' name we pray and believe. As I said, today is our topic for today is destined for the next level. As you all know, things have been really difficult for us from the beginning of last year and even until today. We have gone through situations in which we never expected to go through. For an example, children, nowadays we don't go for birthdays like we used to, right?
Yes.
We don't go for ceremonies and graduation ceremonies in which we were used to going. Nowadays, we don't interact with our friends and families like we used to. In short, life has been really tough and unbearable, and some of us want to give up. Lucky for us who are believers, the Lord has not left us. He has not forgotten us. He is a God of his word, a promise keeper. Whatever he promised in your life, he will fulfill it. Amen?
Amen.
Today, our text is from Isaiah chapter 43, verse 18 to 19. Our text is from
Isaiah chapter 43,
verse 18 to 19. If you're there, say amen.
Amen.
It says, forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. Now it's see, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. From this scripture, we get three major lessons. The first one is to forget the past. The first one is to
forget the past.
Life before COVID and the life today is very different. Before COVID, we could go out with our friends and play like we were used to doing. We could go for birthdays and celebrations and ceremonies and meals, and there will be no serious restrictions. But the lifestyle today has changed. Nowadays, every time when you get out of the house, we have to be putting on masks. Everywhere we go, we have to wash and sanitize our hands, keep distance, stay away from social gatherings. In short, life has changed completely. But the good thing is that the corona might have changed life completely. But one thing corona cannot, will not, and does not change is God. God remains the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Amen?
Amen.
I said, as much as life has changed, but one thing Corona cannot change, will not change, and does not change is God. Amen?
Amen.
Our second point is preparation for the next level. Our second point is? We see this from the book of Genesis chapter 40 verse 1 to 23 and Genesis 41, 1 to 40. This is just basically the story of Joseph. Joseph was a good man, yet he was imprisoned for wrongs he had not done. What I believe that the Lord did this, allowed it to happen so that he can be prepared for the great future that was coming ahead of him. As you see, while in jail, he interpreted a king's servant dream. And a few years later, the king had a dream in which no one in the whole Egypt could interpret. But then the king's servant reminded the king there is a man in the jail called Joseph who could interpret dreams. And after interpreted, he was made the second highest official in Egypt. So sometimes God allows us to go through hardships so that we can be prepared for the next level. Amen?
Amen.
Some of us have gone through loss of loved ones. Like I myself, I lost a relative and it was really tough for us. But the Lord has taken you, it has taken us through. Amen?
Amen?
Some of our parents and family members have contracted the COVID-19. Some of our parents have lost their jobs and businesses. The lifestyle has changed, which made us to relocate from the way we live, our schools, our homes, and in short, everything changed. But one thing, according to Psalms 84:11, if you're there, say amen. So according to Psalms 84:11, it says, "For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good thing does he withhold from those whose way of life is blameless." Meaning, the Lord does not withhold good things from his children. Meaning, and it says there, from whose way of life is blameless. That means parents and children, we need to portray Christ in everything that we do. Children, you cannot say that you are committed to Christ when you cheat in your exams, you lie to your parents, you steal other people's and belongings. And parents, you can't say that you are a Christian parent when you are involved in bad politics, corruption, tribalism, and so forth. So we need to portray Christ in everything that we do so that the Lord does not withhold his blessings away from us. And it says that life is tough. Yes, life is tough. But God is faithful and he will restore us back to where we were. He is taking us back and he's taking us to a greater level, even the one where we were before. Amen? Thirdly, is God's next level. God has already taken us to the next level, parents and children, by teaching us to live by faith. Many of the families today live by faith, not knowing how they will go by the day. They don't know how they will get food and all the necessities they need. But they just live by faith that the Lord is going to provide. Their faith has no facts, has no payslips, has no businesses. So what am I trying to say? In everything we need, the Lord has taken us to the next level by teaching us to live by faith. COVID-19 has brought some blessings into our lives. For example, is the way people today live by faith. They live by faith because before we could live by knowing that there'll always be money in the bank. But now things have changed. Things have become different. And so today people are living differently. They live by faith, and that's now God's next level. Also, there is the new ways of doing things, new ways of life. In short, people have found new ways in which they can generate income and live the normal way, but observing the government protocols, like the online businesses, the online schools, the online church, like what we do today. Thirdly, for even us children, I'm sure some of us have discovered talents even during this pandemic that we never knew we had. Some of us discovered we could cook, we could sing, and beadwork, and the knitting, you know. And fourthly is the better family connections. We connect with our families today much better than we used to even before the COVID. Normally, before COVID, our parents would travel from one place to another, working, and we didn't have a close relationship with them. But now that they are working from home, now we have a better and better connection with our parents and one another. We understand one another better. So, do not allow distractions. Stay focused on the goal. God gave us a word as Citam at the beginning of the year, and today we still stand by it, that we are destined for the next level. Amen? As Citam, at the beginning of the year, we were given a vision, a word, destined for the next level. And today, we are standing by it, that in everything that we go through, in each and every challenge we go through, we are destined for the next level. So brothers and sisters, as I conclude, what am I trying to say? Have faith. Do not lose hope. The Lord is with you. In everything that you go through, the Lord has always been with you, and He will be with you until the end. Even after the end, the Lord is going to be with you. But you must have Christ in your heart. You must have the Spirit in your heart to be able to testify even when things are going wrong. So, according to Acts 1:8. So we must have Jesus in our heart. We must have Christ in our heart for us to be delivered from all these situations that we have. So, parents and children back at home, have you given your life to Jesus? Have you lost hope and are at the end of the world? Are you looking and desiring for a new level? Jesus is the answer for every solution. Thank you and be blessed.
Wow, what a word. Thank you so much, Kimberly. Let's appreciate Kimberly in a nice way. No. Boys and girls, we do it nicely. We do like this. And we say, oh yeah. Okay? Yeah? As we appreciate. We can do that again. Yeah? Let's start. Oh yeah. Yes, yes. Thank you so much. We want also to appreciate Ian, we want to appreciate Nathan, we want to appreciate Ivy, we want to appreciate Rashid, we want to appreciate Alvis for the good job that they have done today as we did our celebration Sunday. And I want also to appreciate every parent who have supported us through our DVBS. They have prepared the children, they have allowed them to participate and also to watch Hope TV and also to listen in. Thank you so much, parents. Thank you also, pastors, for the good job, for encouraging the children, and for also teaching us all those lessons. May God bless you. We want also to appreciate Hope Media for the wonderful job and for the production. May the Lord continue to bless you. And for everyone else who helped us in the puppetry, in all the segments, even if I have not mentioned you by name, remember, God values your work, and may the Lord bless you. And finally, to our children, thank you so much for making DVBS 2021 colorful and beautiful. May the Lord continue to bless you. And indeed, as we have said, you are destined for the next level. Yes, yes. And I want to say a prayer for every one of us as we bring our DVBS 2021 to a close. What do we do when we pray? Put our hands together, close our eyes, and we say a prayer. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for giving us a wonderful DVBS 2021. We want to thank you for everyone who've participated and made our production a big success. And we want to pray that, Lord, you will bless them. And indeed, as we have declared that they are destined for the next level, may they experience the next level. We thank you for the speaker of the word today, Kimberly. We want to pray that you will bless her, that you continue to anoint her and to use her for the glory and for the honor of your name. Even Lord God, as we continue with our online services, we want to pray that you will bless us, and we continue to pray that children, Lord, we will not contract COVID-19 as they prepare to go back to school, that indeed you will watch over them and protect them. We honor your name and we thank you, and this is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Now it is time to give our offering. As the saying goes, it's time to give, it's time to be blessed. Now I'd like to do a short prayer. Mighty Father, I come for you today to say thank you, Mighty Father. We do not take anything you give us for granted, Jesus Christ. We thank you for good health. We thank you for all the jobs that you have given our parents, oh Mighty Father. And we thank you that you have always put a plate of food on the table every night and every morning, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name I pray and believe. Amen. Now, you can use the paybill number down below. Thank you so much for giving, and God bless you.